right, let's hear it for Fairleigh Dickinson University, the Knights, with great alumni like Peggy Noonan and Christine O'Donnell. They've done it. They have proven what Americans have known all along. Watching Fox News makes you dumber. No kidding. Survey shows people who have no exposure to news media are better informed than people who actually watch Fox News. A new study from the university says the folks in Chris Christie's state of New Jersey found some media outlets, especially Fox News, lead people to be less informed than those who say they don't watch any news at all. For example, the study found Fox viewers were 18 points less likely to know that Egyptians overthrew their government than those who watch no news at all. After controlling for other news sources, partisanship, education, and other demographic factors, the study is just the latest in a series of surveys, all showing Fox News viewers are significantly less informed than others on just about every topic, including global warming, healthcare, the Islamic Cultural Center near Ground Zero. Now, how could that be? The Iraq War, and of course, the 2010 election. And it's no secret why Fox News hosts spew misinformation on a daily basis. Here's just a sample.
It's like a derivative of actual pepper. It's a food product, essentially.
Muffin Gate, $16 per muffin.
The Obama administration adding a Christmas tree tax.
And Mr. Redicliffe actually used to work for this company. He sends his attack dog, Jacques Steinberg, out, that fellow right there, the writer for the New York Times, to do these hit pieces.
Hit piece? How about the fact that they altered the photos? Compare the actual picture of editor Stephen Redicliffe to the one they used. They yellowed his teeth, blackened his eyes, receded his hairline, and here's reporter Jacques Steinberg and what Fox used. They gave him a bigger nose, and again, blackened his eyes and yellowed his teeth. They report, you decide.
The $16 muffin, $16 muffin, guess what? The death panels are back.
Critics now claim the administration is actually pressuring certain disabled veterans to, quote, hurry up and die.
Okay, but can you tell me one person on Fox News, just one, was told this audience that they'll go to jail if they don't buy health insurance? You don't know anybody on Fox News, because there hasn't been anyone, that said people will go to jail if they don't buy mandatory insurance.
I don't have universal health care.
Now, let's get the...
Well, you will soon.
or
I'll go to jail.
Yeah, are you going to be a conscientious objector to health care?
You know, that's the first time in history in our country where just to be a citizen, just to not go to jail,
right,
you have to buy something.
I think you should go to prison for this cause.
Really?
I do.
Yeah.
All right,
that would be fun. I'll help you.
More muffin scandal for $16 muffins. Global warming, where are you? We want you back.
We don't reduce our carbon emissions. Aliens might come and kill us.
$16 muffin. I want to taste that muffin. I want to remind you not to make statements you can't back up on this network.
We didn't invade Iraq.
Did we go through Congress to invade, to go to war?
We did not have a terrorist attack on our country during President Bush's term.
We don't do that on this network. And you might be wondering, Fairleigh Dickinson University, where did they get all that money to commission that study? Not state money. It's a private school. And they love privatization, don't they? Let's hear it for the Knights. Coming up, everything old is new again. Newt Gingrich tops the polls. Even the Republicans think he lacks strong moral character. It shows you what Republicans really care about. Bill Press and Joe Madison join me next.